Hello friends, welcome to this new tutorial for automating manual tasks. Today, we will discover the Google API for text-to-speech. This series of video is following my video about flashcards, where I explained how you can use flashcards to improve your journey to language fluency. I will share with you several tips to create automatically flashcards with vocabulary list, oral transcriptions, and pictures. Today, we will understand how to use Google Text-to-Speech API, GTTS, with Python to get oral transcription in any language. So when you will be studying using Anki flashcards,
通知.
You'll have oral transcription to practice your listening and speaking abilities. Let's build this cool solution. So, now we're ready to start. First, we import the libraries that we need to perform the extraction. So we don't need actually pandas, but we need GTTS. And if you want to download it, it's pip install GTTS. So this is the Google text-to-speech free library. Then you have access, if you want to have access to a DXL file, you will use XRRD. So this is the library I'm using to open the Excel file. Which Excel file I'm talking about? This one. So this is the one that you are going to use for your flashcards, for instance. On the first column, I put the sentence that I want to extract the text-to-speech. And in the second column, I put the language. So of course, for you, you may have only one language. I just use several languages for the example here. So you may not need this column, and you can hard code it in the API query. Then we have some additional settings for the visuals, and then we open the file. So the first step is I'm going to define a function that will take as an input. So I will call it do TTS, text-to-speech. The first input will be the word, so it can be a word or sentence, and the language. The second input will be the language. Okay, so it will return TTS. This TTS will be the function GTTS that you are importing from GTTS, but written in a different way. The text would be the word. The second parameter is the language, so here language, and you can add another option called slow. I don't know what's the impact. I try true and false, it's not changing, but just in case, sometimes the text to speech can be fast and I want it to be slow, so I put it slow, especially if you are learning a new language. Then you will need to define the file name of your mp3. So here what I usually do, I take the first 10 characters of the sentence and I add mp3. Of course, I don't forget the dot. And then you can save. So I save. So for me, it's in gtts/m, and here I put format filing. I think we're good now. So we just have, the only thing that we have to do is to set up the loop that will go through all the rows and perform the function to do the query. So let's do this. So first we need to define the end. So I'm going to use a while loop, and for this I need to define the end of the loop. So here it will be the number of rows that you have in your Excel spreadsheet. I can't print it just in case. Transcription, yeah, format, and I take row end, boom. Then I need to initiate this variable row that will be used to count. So while row is below row end, what do I do? So word equals, so I need to define the first argument, so the word. So here you select the sheet, and you take the value of the cell. So here, first element is the row and the second element is zero because it's the first column. Then you do the same for the language, sheet.cellValue. So here again, row, but here it's one because it's the second column. And then easy peasy, you just do TTS. So that's the function that we created here, word, language, boom. Okay, just in case we have some issues, let's print some logs. So first I will put just the words that we have translated, and then we are going to count the number of... So here it looks to be a bit useless, but imagine that you can have several thousands of transcription to do. Format. Well, the first thing I will do is put a word, then I will put row, and I will put row end. I think we're good. And the last thing that you definitely shouldn't forget is to increment the count parameter. If not, you will have an infinite loop. Yeah, I think we're good. So we can launch. So we have force transcription in time, which is good. So if I open the file, let me open the first result. So bonjour. And then I will open the one in Italian.
Bonjour.
So okay, I think you can hear it. Then if I do the Italian one.
Dove abiti?
And finally the one in Chinese.
你是哪里人?
So where are you from? It's not 你在哪里,是哪里人? Yeah, where are you from? So I hope it was clear enough. If you have any question, feel free to let them in the comment section.